Hey guys, Erin here, and we are just going to jump straight into today's video. This is ash. It is a standard ink. I'm not really sure what this is going to be. Like, maybe it's kind of greenish. I guess we'll just break out the swatch cards and let's see what we get. So here is the swatch card, and I've got my paintbrush. We'll go ahead and put the ink on, and I'm going to say right now, this is kind of weird. I don't know. It's like really watery and kind of thin, which I guess is fine, but not usually, my favorite kind of inks to play with. So we'll go ahead and test it with the dip pen, and it does flow quite beautifully off the dip pen and does have a pretty color. So that's nice. I still can't decide what the color is. Like, maybe it's kind of a greenish, but it looks sort of gray as well. So we'll definitely have to see how that dries. We'll put the name here. And then we'll go ahead and put that off to the side to dry. And let's test it on our papers. So this is the Nemesine. And this one, wow, look at that. It's flowing, but it actually dries really quickly. And then it's pooling. And there's a little bit of, I almost want to say granulation, like, I have a couple watercolors that do that. So that is interesting. And you can almost see a couple different colors peeking out as well. So that'll be cool to see when it dries. Here is our Rhodia. And I will say that it does pull easier on the Rhodia, which is fascinating because thus far everything has been dry. And look at that. It's just like pooling in the one area. And again, a little bit of that color shifting kind of granulation. Let's go ahead and try it in the Hobonichi. We've got day three here. And test it out. Again, look at it. It's so, I don't know. I would say, like, at first glance, I'm going to say, I don't like this ink. But I have a feeling that maybe once it dries, I might like it. I don't know. This is me just still trying to be optimistic. So we'll go ahead and add just a little bit more color here. Very, very weird. So again, we get a little bit of that color changing. The chromatography is going to be really interesting. So let's go ahead and let that dry. Happening right now. I think this calls for a little further exploration. To say that this ink was alienish might be a correct term. So look at this. We have this almost beautiful blue, some grays. There's hints of red in there as well. Yeah, really cool, but very strange. Not so much of the shading there with that blue. You can see hints of the red on the Nemesine, but really not a lot. Again, a little bit of bleeding there, but I put it on heavy. Here you can see a really dark ring around it and a bit of blue, but not really much of that reddish color at all on the Rhodia. So that is interesting. You can actually see a little of the reddish ghosting on the back. Here is the Hobonichi. Again, you can see some of those pinkish reds there and the blue. So definitely you can see it better on the Tomo River paper. Again, I put it on pretty heavy, so there's a bit of the ghosting. So this is just fascinating to me. Now look at this chromatography. It's kind of like a little rainbow. So you have your reds. You can see a bit of an orange shift in there from the mix of the red and the yellow. There's a little bit of green and then a lot of the blue. So you're going to get that purpley kind of color with the mix of the blue and the red. And then that hint of yellow is going to add that more grayer color to it. So definitely a fun artist's ink to play with. Now we'll go ahead and open up the little journal here. Here is yesterday's day two. And we'll flip to a new page. We'll go ahead and grab our washi tape as usual. I'm going to speed this up pretty quick. And I will say, I don't know what happened. You know, just you have some of those days where things just don't seem to go right. Yeah, that was today. My camera somehow shifted the focus off. So the entire part here moving forward is a bit blurry until the end. I apologize about that in advance. There's really not much I can do with it except have just taken out the whole video, but I wanted to be as honest with the process as possible. So I'm leaving this blurry mess in there. And I will say though, look how cool this ink is. Like when you pull it up and you have the reds, I won't say anymore. I'll put on some music. I am going to super speed this through just to save your eyes. And then I will come back near the end and we can chat about it. Pause for a moment here. I just wanted to show you this cool dip pen that I have. It is a bamboo. I don't know if it's real bamboo, but look how neat it is with that brown colored glass. It's like an amber colored glass on the tip. So I was going to start trying to use it. I didn't have enough ink in the inkwell, so I'm just going to go ahead and start pulling from the bottle. I started to doodle. I thought it would be fun to doodle, and I wished in hindsight that I would have just stuck with playing with just the ink itself without the doodling, because it did make the video a little longer and I started to get a little bit frustrated. As you can tell, it was pretty tedious. I really did enjoy how it was turning out, and then I came back the next day and so we'll get there. I'll come back in once we get there. So I got pulled away yesterday and didn't get to finish it, but I did play with a little bit of the swatch. This actually turned out like a face, and I did not do that on purpose. I just was playing with the ink. But look at, you've got that beautiful blue and the gray together. That's on Tomo River. And then I did try a swatch on a cold-pressed watercolor paper, and I did not get any of that cool coloring, none of the blues or really any of the pinks. So the hot-pressed paper has been really good for bringing out those multiple colors, but I just wanted to show the artists out there that not all paper is the same. I should have just left it alone right here. I have a baby wipe and I'm pulling back some of that ink, and I do really enjoy how it's changing those colors, but I started to get a little carried away. No, I won't say I get carried away. I feel like this piece turned into what I was feeling at the moment, and I think a lot of times this happens with artists. I wanted to keep pushing it and seeing where I could go, and today is all about exploration, so I'm gonna roll with that. But it was like the bottom was all of this chaos, all of this emotion, and the top was like this perfectness right there. And I feel like that is such a piece for how, not even the world, but like how I am right now. I want to come across like I know exactly what I'm doing and that everything is great, but then there's all these emotions that are whirling underneath that I'm almost afraid to show. So today I'm proudly showing, like, I'm not sure if I like this piece, but I really enjoy the emotion that came out from underneath it. And I hope that you guys like it too. So despite all of the hiccups, the ups and the downs, this ink really truly does have a place in my heart, and I look forward to playing with it more in the future. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today on day 3, and I hope to see you back tomorrow for day 4. Until next time, happy creating.